Today we are going to learn about the environment module system. Before I explain how to use our module system, we need to know a couple things first. The path is an environment variable that tells your shell the directories where executable programs are located. In other words, the path environment variable is how the shell knows what to do when you type the ls command, for example. However, what happens if you want to use a program that is not on our default path? We must first add that directory containing the executable programs to our path. We can do so like this. This will add all the executables from the bin directory in my home directory to my path so I can use them. Note that you separate the directories you wish to add with a colon. Also note that we are appending to our current path instead of overwriting it, because we reference the path variable at the end of this command. This process can get tedious, however, especially when you have to manage multiple versions of the same software. This is where the environment module system comes in. It works by modifying the path environment variable to tell your shell where to find new programs that it doesn't know about by default. This allows us to easily run software that does not come pre-installed as part of the system. The other thing we need to know is when a program runs, it usually requires some external libraries. One of the ways the system knows where to find the libraries to load for the program is through another environment variable called the ldlibrary path. Our module system updates this variable automatically so that a program always has access to the libraries it needs to run. I will explain some of the more helpful module commands to use. You can display a list of all the available modules we have installed simply by typing module available. Here we can see that it printed out all the different versions of the software or modules that we have available. You can also simply type avail as a shortcut. You can also see different versions of a specific software by using the same command. For example, if I wanted to see the different versions of the GNU compiler collection that we have available, I can simply type module available compiler underscore GNU. We can use any of the available modules that we have installed simply by typing module load. For example, if I wanted to use the Julia language, right now, if I type Julia, it says the command is not found. This is because the system cannot find Julia on my path. However, if I type module load Julia and then the version I want to use, we can see that it has been loaded by typing module list. This will list all of the modules that we have currently loaded and available for use. Now when I type in Julia, it does what we expect it to do. This is because the module command automatically updates the path environment variable for us. Also note that if you don't explicitly load a module, there are some default modules that are automatically loaded for you when you log in. We change these default modules from time to time. Now let's say I wanted to use a newer version of Julia. I can do so by typing module load Julia 0.3.10 underscore GNU 510. But as we can see, it tells us that it cannot load the new version of Julia because it conflicts with the version of Julia we already have loaded. So we must first unload Julia by typing module unload Julia and then load it again. Or we can do module swap and type the newer version to swap out the older version that we have already loaded like this. Now, as you can see, we have the new version of Julia loaded and available to use. You can also unload all the modules that you have currently loaded by typing module purge instead of typing module unload and then specifying all the modules we have currently loaded. As with most other programs, you can type man module for more help. You can also use module help and then the name of the module that you want help for, or module what is and the name of the module. Please be aware, some modules do not have a help or what is command. Thank you for watching, and happy researching.